Searching for the witch Ciri had quarreled with, Geralt ran into an old friend, Kira Metz. The sorceress told the witcher about a masked mage. Ciri had seemed to have taken shelter in his hideout. The witcher set off to find it, with Kira in tow. Ciri had never reached the elven mage, yet the wild hunt had. The ghostly retinue was one step ahead of Geralt, or so it seemed. The witcher felt that always lost, until Kira gave him a new lead. The Crones of Crookback Bog.
Right in the chops, see?
Where'd you say you heard this?
could use some hair of the hound. Nat, fancy an outing to find that sheepy.
Bring the Smiths, lads. Get two plus.
Ever heard of preventive arse whooping?
Folk don't object to your white monk.
Come on, Roach.
Run, Roach. faster.
Boy, you there. Oh, look, we got ourselves a customer.
Not about to buy anything from you.
Afraid you're mistaken. If we're to let you pass, you gotta pay.
And if I don't?
Then you die.
Tell you what. Give you a chance to earn something. Anything you take off me, you get to keep. Bad idea. What? Lost your nerve? Come on.
Foreman Rowe!
Hang on.
That'll never work!
Fucking shit!
Fiends howling.
Come on. Let's go! Take it easy. Just destroy it.
Greetings.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Farewell.
If I ever have a son, I'll name him Geralt. So you're a man well traveled. So tell me, don't beat me when you're asleep. Rough. Ye seek trouble?
Every doctor in bar, it'll be. The squid is coming up in our spot. Not looking good.
Greetings!
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Farewell.
Let's go! Come on, Roach! Run, Roach. Run, Roach. Giddy up.
Come on now. On the right path.
Doug went in the kitchen, stole a hunk of meat.
Cook gave him a licking, strung him by his feet.
Cook then bled him empty, stripped his skin off clean.
Laughed and said how tasty, best sausage I have seen.
Cook's a stupid killer, shouldn't have ate the pup. Now we'll light a fire. Gonna roast him up.
1, 2, 3. The one to fetch the kindlings. Thee!
Interesting rhyme.
Don't know you. Go away.
A young woman got lost in the swamp. She has ashen hair and a scar on her face. You kids see anyone like that?
Ain't no lassies here.
What am I?
You're no lassie. Lassies got tits.
They do. Heard an old man say once, when the army was here, he says, "Hide them lassies in the woods. They's dazzling the soldiers with their tits. And it's torturing the poor lads." That's what he said.
Listen, the girl I'm looking for, she's in trouble. I understand you might not want to help me, but you could try to help her.
How do you know she was here?
I heard she visited the witches in the swamp.
But there's no witches here.
There's only frogs.
And snakes.
And Johnny.
What's this talk? What kind of jabbering is this, eh? No one allowed here. Just kids. My kids. They're allowed. But who are you, wearing swords like a bandit?
Just talking to the kids. Asked them if they'd seen a young woman.
I was a lovely young woman. Wore a long, beautiful braid my mummy did up for me. Had dresses with flowers on them.
Maybe you've seen her. Young, ashen hair.
Your betrothed?
Daughter, actually.
Daughter? My dear, sweet little daughter and her sister. Where are they now? Maybe they've come to some harm.
A bit of help, please. A young, ashen-haired woman. Just need to know if you've seen her.
What are you looking at, children? Wash your hands, we'll go catch crickets.
Won't learn anything from you.
Aye, because I don't know nothing.
That Johnny knows. He knows a lot. When I ask him something, he says, "Wait, I'll scratch my arse and tell you."
Ugly word. What you saying? To the hut. You'll stand in a corner. I'll make sure you do. You, be gone. Be gone! Can't come in here. Not allowed in here.
I just want to talk to the boy.
Not allowed. It's not allowed.
He won't talk to you anyway. Gran don't like you. And Johnny's made up. And stranger still, kids.
Just tell me where I can find Johnny.
Johnny's made up.
Be gone. Be gone.
Wonder where he's from.
Why don't you want to talk about Johnny? One of you knows about him. The others must too.
It's just him who's pals with Johnny. They pick mushrooms and hunt snails. But Gran says Johnny's made up.
Have any of you ever seen Johnny?
Of course. Looks just like him.
Then why do you say he's made up?
Gran says so. And Gran knows lots.
Does your gran treat you right? She ever hurt you?
Never.
When we're bad, she cries.
She's scared. Says strangers might take us. And we'll disappear.
The boy who plays with Johnny. He must be brave.
Not brave, just stupid.
Sat his bare bum on an anthill once. But yeah, he plays with Johnny. He don't listen to Gran and goes in the woods, and then he's got to have a time out.
And eat snails. Yuck.
The girl I mentioned is in danger. You gotta help me get your Gran away from the hut so I can talk to Johnny's friend.
All right. But you gotta do something for us, too. Play hide and seek. Gran never does. Says her feet hurt.
Let's play. You hide, but if I find you, you have to help me talk to the boy who knows Johnny.
He thinks he'll find us easy.
Means he's never hid from the black ones.
No looking, and you have to count out loud. All your fingers, toes, too.
One, two, three, 18, 19, 20. Ready or not, here I come. See you. Come out. Found you. You can stop hiding.
How'd you find me?
There you are.
Found me.
Looks like rain. No one left hiding.
You're a wizard, right? Gonna show us some tricks when we get to the cottage.
No, we'll talk about your promise. Found you all. Now you gotta keep your word and help me talk to Johnny's friend.
Why wouldn't we? Promised, didn't we?
Don't be afraid.
Don't know nothing.
I won't hurt you.
Where's Gran?
She's busy. Why are you scared to talk?
I'm not scared of nothing.
You're all scared of something. Would have told me about Johnny otherwise.
I'm worried about Johnny. He don't come round no more. Once, when we was mushroom picking, I saw his burrow. But Gran yelled at me. Said not to talk to strangers, cause then kids go missing. She worries about Johnny too. Though she says he's made up.
Where are you and your friend's parents?
Dad, some starved, others were killed, like mine. One day, I went out at dawn to look for berries in the woods. Still some around back then. When I was coming home, I heard the yells, then laughing. Went up and hid in the bushes near the woods. My mum yelled. And the soldiers laughed. Lay my paw down by the barn door. His head clean off. And then my mom.
It's all right. That's enough. I just want to talk to Johnny. He could know more than you.
Not gonna hurt him, right? Because he's real. He's not made up.
I'm not gonna hurt him.
Johnny used to be boy, because Gran liked listening to his songs. When we was picking mushrooms, Johnny said he saw a girl with ashen hair in the swamp.
Where can I find Johnny?
There's a little meadow,
on the edge of the swamp. This strange tree grows there. Look around. You'll see him.
Thank you. Johnny's real. He must leave prints. Small footprint. Johnny's been through here. Tracks lead to a burrow. Wonder what's inside.
Johnny? Don't be afraid.
You're a Bucca? A Luton? Ah, a Godling. Not many of you left. I'm looking for a woman with ashen hair. Seen her? Tell me everything, from the start. Where did you see her? What was she doing? It's important to me. Why not? You know the kids from the clearing well? Don't be afraid. Not gonna hurt anyone. What's wrong?
Can't talk? Why? Lost your voice? Can I help you somehow? Want me to follow you? No choice, I guess. Stay close to me. This the place? Let me look around. Something's on the ledge? Something that'll get you your voice back? Guess I gotta make this climb. Come on. Maybe he meant this bottle.
A pack of pickled peppers by the Pontar.
Done celebrating?
My favorite words! Life without savoring the sound of surreptitious shenanigans is like licking snails through a clock. Thank you for this, noble whoever you are. Long be your life.
Hang on a minute. I helped you, now you help me.
Would you turn this beautiful act of altruism into a banal bartering of favors?
How'd you lose your voice?
One morning I awoke and opened my mouth for my usual bout of singing with the thrushes. Lo and behold, no sound escaped. I tried and tried, almost burst a blood vessel. Then I went to the village, because word has it, the new cunning woman works miracles. But people began crying out, "A smudger! A smudger!" and sick their dogs on me. Do I look like a smudger to you?
Not a bit.
Well, I thought not. So it must be the crone's doing. Who else would curse me? Blackbird friend of mine located my voice, but I was helpless to retrieve it.
Couldn't ask a raven friend to just give you the bottle?
Ravens serve the crones. They don't help no one.
I'm looking for a young, ashen-haired woman. See anyone like that?
Did I ever? Remember it as if it were yesterday. Soon as I woke, I went to empty my bowels. My favorite part of the day. Defecating to the sunrise. Downright glorious. Suddenly, heard a bang, so loud it couldn't have been me. And that lass appeared, out of nowhere. Young, ashen-haired, just like you said. Wounded and panting to boot. She raced off towards the children's hut, quick as if the crones were after her. I yelled some unpleasantries. She disturbed my mourn. Sadly, I'd lost my voice, so I don't think she heard me.
She ran off toward the orphanage. Kids could know something, or the old woman who takes care of them.
Oh, that old hag don't speak to strangers, and you're a stranger.
Will she talk to you?
I have spoken to her, got my ways. So be it. You helped me, and I'm no bore. Come with me.
What
It's clear, not a crone in sight. I need to sing to Gran. That ought to calm her.
Little Johnny softly gazed, fire waning pale. Hop! But Spark jumped out and whispered, "Listen, I've a tale."
You got your voice back.
I did, though I seem to have lost an octave somewhere in the process. I shall look for it when I get home.
You're not allowed here, Johnny. You shouldn't have come.
Calm down, Gran. Don't get angry. It's not good for you.
The woman I asked about earlier.
Forgive me, Gran, but this fellow absolutely must talk to the ladies.
No, it is not allowed.
Please, it's important.
The fellow will be quiet. Gran, please hear me out. I found little Yagna when she got lost, did I not? Did I break Ginny's fever too? I did. I ask anything in return? No. Didn't even fuss about my stolen voice. Well, now I want something. Gran, help this fellow. Because otherwise he'll pester me day and night, even during potty time. His lass is missing. Mayhaps the ladies can help find her, eh?
Well, since you put it that way, Johnny, I'll help him. Come with me. Johnny's a good lad, though the ladies don't like him. No, foul creature, they say, don't like him.
Who are the women in the tapestry?
Those are the ladies. Ladies lovely, with power o'er all, beseech I thee, answer my call. Before you a worm crawls, wretched and small.
How dare you disturb our rest, woman?
I'm looking for the woman with ashen hair. I know you met her. Where is she?
Oh, he's impatient. Perhaps he only likes ashen-haired girls.
The young woman. She's my daughter by choice. I raised her.
If she's shapely, what does it matter?
Matters to me.
I believe we've hit a nerve. He's bubbling like well-fed yeast. Oh, that's how I like him.
It's clear you met her. Tell me everything.
That was blunt. Well, perhaps it's for the best. Tell me, have you got bollocks? Do you fear woodland beasts? Oh, hard times are upon this white-haired one. Brother has turned against brother. The land is soaked in blood. Evil reigns stronger than ever before.
A dark power has surfaced near Dunwarren. It feeds on hatred and disdain. Destroy the beast, and we may be grateful. Tell you all we know about this ashen-haired maid.
Dark power? You need a knight-errant, or a witch-hunter, not a witcher.
The Alderman of Dunwarren will tell you all. Remember to collect payment from him after you complete your task. And now our servant will bring you the dagger.
A dagger? What for?
When the Alderman sees this dagger, he'll know we sent you. He'll aid with all.
I'll talk to the Alderman, but I can't promise anything.
Move, woman! Give the young man the dagger!
And you, White One, return only once you've completed the task.
Aye, mistress, right. On me way. Dagger. Gotta bring the dagger. The dagger. For you. Lady told me to give it you. Here it is. The dagger. Place the alderman's payment on the stone. Stone bear. Stone shear, stone nose, stone ears.
Catch his breath! Fucking bastard!
Granddad told me a dragon nested in the hill.
Greetings. Nice village.
Aye.
A real pearl of the swamps.
If you say so.
You get by all right?
Aye, winter to winter. Somehow we survive.
Recognize this dagger?
Aye, master. I didn't know you belonged to them.
Don't belong to anyone. Down to business. I want to get this done quickly.
Ah, so that's how it's to be.
I'm supposed to help solve your problem. Tell me what it is. Just the essentials.
The war awoke an ancient power. An evil one that feeds on bloodshed. Nightmares haunt our nights and days. Folks sleepwalk from their homes, never to return. Under the tree on the Whispering Hillock they lie. Unburied all. Fathers, sons, daughters, and mothers. Folk are afeard to move them. You must go there. The dark powers must be cast off.
Ladies of the Wood don't know what this power is.
They know all. Old Thekla claimed they'd be punishing us.
folk stop respecting them. Some even call them witches. But must not be they, for they sent you.
I'll look around the Whispering Hillock.
You be careful, Master Witcher. Don't ye treat this evil light.
Poor cutthroats. Who, I ask?
Others call them the Crones, but you call them the Ladies of the Wood.
Those who name them Crones, them's artless fools. The Ladies of the Wood have watched over this land for ages.
In what way?
They drive out evil powers. They say 100 springs ago, they saved Velen from a plague of werewolves ravaging our flocks.
Good health to you. Farewell.
Making me a slingshot. Gonna hunt.
Your granddad told me a dragon nest was in the hills once upon a time.
Milk, freshly curdled milk. Eggs straight from the coop, nary a trace of shit on them.
Show me what you sell. Take it easy. Faster.
Giddy up. That's it, Roach.
A voice from within the tree.
Thank you.
medallion's humming. Place of power, it's gotta be. Solved your problem. Just in case, though, avoid the Whispering Hillock for a while.
Cannot be. Where's something lurking there?
Believe me, you don't want to know.
What have you done?
Some being had come to possess the tree's heart. I destroyed the heart and its inhabitant.
So it were a ghost? Will it be back?
No. The crones, or the ladies of the wood as you call them, said to remind you about payment. Take it you know what they want?
Aye, I do. Give me the dagger. Be back soon.
There's payment. Take it to the ladies, will you?
What the hell was that?
'Tis our pact. You're a stranger. You don't know life here. It's honest pay for their protection.
So, all those ears in the woods...
Put it out your mind, master. You soon be leaving and we must tarry on. Our young'uns and their young'uns after them. No gods nor masters watch over Velen. The land is no man's. He who wants to survive... must seek his own protectors.
Real life, you're different than you were in the tapestry.
But now we must talk to our white-haired friend.
I know that, Mark. This is Anna, the wife of the Baron of Crow's Perch.
She belongs to no man.
Deal. I did my part, Now you do yours.
Mischievous, stubborn, and selfish.
Don't believe you. They say you always keep your word, so tell me everything, exactly as it happened. You tried to kill her. Tried to butcher her like an animal and eat her. You tried to kill her.
Yeah?
Got their asses whipped like a Novigrad whore.
You surprised? They tried to dance with a witcher.
Where'd he come from anyway?
Well, how should I know? You so curious? Ask him yourself.
Got eyes like a cat. You catch mine too.
You, white one, think your two swords can take on 40?
Pot of cider for you, or a bit of dry curd. Me lad is not exactly bursting, but what I got sure to please.
Like to take a look. Farewell.
What did I do to deserve your...
Yeah?
How can I help you?
Take care now.
How may I assist you?
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. So long.
May I assist you?
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. So long.
you're muttering.
Stinks an Ifgardian corpse to me.
I'm listening. What do you come to me with?
Got news of your wife.
Plowing hell, why'd you not say so forthwith? Where is she? Why have you not returned with her?
She's in Crookback Bog. Got food, a place to live, and keeps herself busy. Didn't look like she had the slightest desire to leave.
You were to bring her back, not report on the condition she lives under!
I was supposed to find her, and I did. That was our deal, nothing more.
You still think me rotten to the core. A base bastard, don't you? You believe I alone am at fault for what happened here.
Actually, that's exactly what I think.
The world might seem black and white to you witches, but for us common folk, it's shades of grey. As is my family's story.
Sorry, but your life story? Just not interested. This isn't a social call. I'm here on business.
Will you at least tell me how Anna wound up in that blasted bog?
Your wife is with the Crones, as their servant.
What the fuck do you mean? What Crones?
Ones who live in Crookback Bog.
Oh, I've heard folk speak of them, and thought it naught but tales to scare the children with. How on earth did she land there?
She made a pact with the Crones and... well, I think she might have lost her mind.
A pact? What the bloody hell?
She was with child, a child she didn't want to bear. Went to the Crones for help. They promised to rid her of the problem in exchange for a year of her service. And they kept their word, in their own twisted way.
What do you mean?
Anna must have thought the child inside her would somehow disappear. Instead, the Crones sapped her of strength, and ultimately forced her body to miscarry. I think that's when she started to lose her mind. Then they placed magic tethers on her. Tethers that cause great pain when tested. A guarantee she'll pay off her debt.
A pact with witches? Bloody nightmare, sounds like some jest. We must get her out. We can't leave her there.
Do what you will, but leave me out of this. You ask me, wading through the swamp to mess with the Crones? Just plain stupid.
What would you have me do? Sit on my ass and wait for her return? I'll send men, go with them myself, and we will pull her out.
I've warned you. What you do, that's your business. In the mood for a round of Gwent?
Ha ha! I'm always in the mood for Gwent.
We'll play another time.
I'm listening. What do you come to me with?
We had a deal. I've done my part. Your turn to do yours.
A word once given. Now what did I last?
Basilisk. It had just attacked you.
Ah, right. gargantuan. One solid brute. It landed right in front of us. I thought we'd breathed our last.
Watch out!
If I don't survive this, you're to take whatever you want from the fortress.
You'll survive!
Let's show this bastard what we're worth! Fuck!
Damn it! I can't leave him like that.
Come on! Bring it on, Horson! Come here!
You have everything?
Yes, thank you.
What you did for me, I shall never forget it.
You helped me as well. When your man brought me here, you fed me, cared for me, had my wounds looked after. We're even now.
You needn't leave. You're in good company here. We'll always have a warm corner for you.
I must leave. Wraiths pursue me. The Wild Hunt. I was foolish to use the power. They're sure to have caught my scent.
The Wild Hunt? Pursuing you?
I'll endanger all of you by remaining here. You must tell the people to bar their doors and windows. And no one is to wander the night.
And you? Where do you think you're going?
Now, I ride for Novigrad. And then, who knows where.
She mounted and rode off. It grew awfully empty without her.
So there's a chance Ciri's still in Novigrad. Thanks for helping her.
It's nothing. Now you've learned what you wanted to know, you must be in a hurry. But if you could...
Spit it out.
I want to go get Anna. Free her. Bring her back. I don't believe she's there willingly.
Must have not heard me. Any journey into the swamp is suicide.
I heard you. Which is why I could use your aid. I've no more tales of Ciri to offer you. But go with me and I'll be generous with what I do have. Very generous.
What'll happen if I don't go with you?
To you? Nothing. Though I'll probably lose a few more men in the swamps. I'm determined to make this journey.
I'll think about it.
Fuck thinking. Just help me. I'll gather my men and ride to Dan Warren. Once you've mulled it over, join us there.
Dare you! Sorry, we was there.
What was that?
You tell me. Man or monster? My men call him Uma and say he's a beast. But he seems a man to me. Just hideous as a huddled shit.
Doesn't look like a monster, but my medallion's trembling. Strange. Where'd you find him?
Funny story, actually. I won him in a game of cards.
Must have been pretty desperate to play for that.
Ah, quit your carping, smartass. Someone wagered him, and we played. If anyone was desperate, it was the bugger's former master.
Funny story. How so?
I went to Novigrad once, to rest, indulge in the city's pleasures. Stayed at a tavern. Cards were kind that day. Had one devilish hand after another. Asked him what he had to wager, and he showed me that sideshow.
Hilarious. Real side-splitter.
Oh, you wouldn't know a good tale from a runny fart.
Proper baron now. Even got a jester.
Aye. Though I feel something's not right with him.
How so?
Well, he seems more beast than man.
No, but he doesn't look dangerous. Time I was on my way. So long.
Farewell. I hope you find your daughter. And prove a good father to her.